Hello everyone, how are you children? I hope everyone is fine. So here I am Deepa Kalantri again with one of your favorite subject, that is discovery. So today again we are going to learn a very interesting activity named as loop glider, and the materials which are needed for the same are as follows. The materials which we need to make a loop glider are: we need a paper which is approximately half of A4 size. We need two strips of cardboard paper which are little bit thick. You can use your old greeting cards, invitation cards, anything, no problem at all. Okay, we need two strips of it. One is small, around 6 to 7 centimeters, and one is big, around 10 to 12 centimeters. Okay, we need one pencil or a pen, one pair of scissors, two-way tape and cello tape. First, we will make a straw out of this paper. For that, we can use a pencil or a pen. We will keep it like this and just rotate it in this way. As the plastic straws are not available in the market, we are making paper straw. You can use a plastic straw also. We get this corner here. We will join this corner with the help of a cello tape. Okay? And then with the help of another pencil, we can remove the pencil which is there inside it. Okay. Once this is done, we will cut the corners like this. So this is our paper straw ready. Very, very simple, right? It will be an eco-friendly straw. Okay. Now the strip, I have taken the bigger strip of 12 centimeters approximately. Join the two ends like this simply and attach it with the help of a cello tape like this. Just use a piece of a cello tape here to join it like this. Like this loop is ready. Similarly, we will make the small loop. It should not be folded in between. Okay, again we will use a piece of cello tape here and just attach the two ends of that strip. This is the small loop. So the two loops are ready. Now with the help of two piece of two-way tape, we will attach one loop at this end and the other loop at this end like this. Now how to attach it? Just take a piece of this two-way tape, joint it here like this. Okay, remove the cover and place the straw on it like this. It is attached. Similarly, you will do for the smaller loop also. And finally, we will get a loop glider like this. So finally we are ready with our loop glider. You can see it, the smaller loop is here and the bigger loop is here. How you are going to play with it? Simply the same as we do with our paper planes which we make earlier. So what we are going to do, we are going to land it like this. We are going to throw it like this. Just remember, the smaller loop should be on the front side and the bigger loop should be on the back side. There is a reason behind it, why we are going to land it like this. What is the science behind it? That we are going to do. Because ultimately in discovery we learn science only. It is related to science, scientific concepts only, right? So let us see. Now this is our loop glider, you can see. Here there is a smaller loop and here there is a bigger loop. What is the function of the smaller loop and what does the bigger loop helps us for? That we should learn. The thing is that the smaller loop helps to cut the air. When we are throwing the loop glider, it will cut the air. Why we need to cut the air? Whenever we want to move in forward direction, we need to cut the medium in which we are. If we are in air, we need to cut the air. If we are in water, we need to cut the water. Right? While swimming we do like this, what we are doing? We are cutting the water. Okay? And what is the function of the bigger loop? The bigger loop helps to balance the glider. Because it should not topple down immediately. it should go to some distance. It should drag the loop glider to some distance. So this bigger loop helps the glider to balance in the air. So ultimately, smaller loop will help us to cut the air and bigger will help to balance the glider. So this is the scientific reason why the loop glider can glide very easily in the air. So I hope you will play with it and enjoy the thing. Yes, I will give you one task. You can try it in the reverse way also and see what happens when you glide the loop glider in this way, when the bigger loop is on the front side and the smaller on the back side. What happens, that you need to see and share it with me. Okay, I hope you will do it and enjoy the thing, right? Okay, thank you.